Hey guys, Angry Monkey here with another Retro Game Treasure unboxing video. And after the unboxing video, I got a very, very, very long pickup section to do. So let's go ahead and get started with this one because this is going to be one of my longest unboxing videos because of how much stuff I've got. So anyway, if you're new to the channel and you're wondering what is Retro Game Treasure, this is a video game service that sends you 3 to 5 video games to your house every month. Gives you 3 to 5 games to your personal collection. This is not a rental service. You get to keep these games. And these games range from a variety of different consoles, from very, very old to somewhat still modern. So you got some old school stuff, Atari and Intellivision. You've got Nintendo stuff, NES, Super Nintendo, 64, GameCube, Wii, as well as the portable stuff, the Game Boy, Game Boy Color, Game Boy Advance, Nintendo DS, and 3DS. You got Sega stuff from the Sega Master System, the Genesis, the Sega CD, and the Dreamcast, and the Game Gear. Don't expect a lot of Sega CD and Dreamcast, though, and yeah, they don't even offer Sega Saturn because how expensive that is, but you might get those. I've gotten a Sega CD before. I've gotten a Sega Dreamcast game in here before, but that was once. So, yeah, anyway. You also have PlayStation stuff, PlayStation 1, 2, 3, and 4, as well as the PSP. As well as original Xbox, Xbox 360, and Xbox One. So, like I said, like plenty of consoles to get games for. And like I said, you get 3 to 5 games from those consoles that you pick. But before we talk about that, let's talk about the wish list and the checklist. So, if you're like me and you've got like this wall of games and you're wondering, well, how am I supposed to avoid getting duplicates? Well, you would help avoid getting duplicates by going on the website, on the survey, and all that stuff, and fill out the checklist feature. But you got to make sure you check off all versions of said game. So, Star Wars Battlefront on PS2, they've got the black label as well as the red label greatest hits version. So, if you got it, make sure you check off both versions unless you want both versions. And also make sure that you go over to original Xbox and check off that you have that version as well, unless you want it on both consoles. That's something that I've learned from experience. So, like, let's just say I get it on PS3, and then I get it for the Xbox 360, and I'm like, oops, I forgot to even check that it's on 360. So, yeah, that's just something to keep in mind when you get your box, to make sure that you update it and make sure you check all versions of it. There's also the wishlist feature, where you can say, hey, these are some games that I'd like to get, and they'll be like, cool, if we get it, we'll possibly put in your box. I mean, don't expect Earthbound, but if you got your Super Nintendo and you want Mario World, yeah, you might get that in your box. But, like, within reason, I mean, go ahead and put Earthbound on there, but you're not going to get it, but go ahead and put it on there. It's not hurting anything. Just don't be upset if you don't get it. But the nice thing is, when you go on the website and fill out the survey, you check off the genres of games that you like. So if you like platformers or shooters or arcade games and beat-em-ups, RPGs, etc., you check off the genres that you like, leave off what you don't like, so that way you don't get sports games. That's kind of one of the big selling points here is, I mean, if you like sports games, if you want, I don't know, NES baseball, cool, more power to you. They probably have a billion copies. But there's a lot of us out there that don't want those games in our collection. It's just kind of a wasted spot for something that could be a better game. But hey, it's your box. But that's just something to keep in mind where you don't get a lot of sports games, which is cool. You can also say that you're like that you've been collecting for a while, condition is important, or no, just give me games. Stuff like that. So, like, on mine, I tend to get at least boxed disc-based games, because I have that in there, because I've got a couple loose games. One of them was so banged up, I'm like, this isn't even going to work. So, yeah. But they got good customer service. So if you do get a damaged game, just message them and be like, hey, I got this game, it doesn't work. They'll add in an additional game to your next box, which is great. So yeah, the genres and the consoles are probably the two most important things, but you can also say like, hey, I'm fine with getting import games, I've got a Super Nintendo mouse, so you can send me those types of games, or I'm okay with rated M games or kid games. There's so many ways to customize it to make this box unique to you. And I guess I've been rambling on long enough. Like I said, I've got a big pickup section ahead of me, so let's just go ahead and open this box. Alright, so first I'm going to, as always, take this box out of frame. We're going to open it up, and so that way you guys don't see what my address is. And as always, we're going to put this box backwards, so that way we don't get spoilers for what our second game is when we pull out our first box. So, what do we got? First, we're going to have our discount airpillows.com, where pills are inflated, not prices, because... What is this? Is there a discount airpillows.com where pills are inflated, not prices? What is... Pregis? But... Well, I'm already disappointed. I don't know if this is going to be a good box, because we got these knockoff airpillows.com where pillows are inflated, not prices. What is this? I don't want those. Although, they're at least inflated. That's more than you can say about the discountyourpillows.com. At least lately I've gotten some that are slightly deflated. So, yeah. Hopefully the games are good, because the discount air pillows are not discountyourpillows.com, where pillows are inflated, not prices. So... first, we got... Okay, I feel four games here. We got... Feels like Intellivision, because it's like a cartridge with a slant. I feel Game Boy Advance game. And two disc-based games, like PS4 or Xbox One. Usually, one would be a PS4 and one would be an Xbox One, but... I guess we'll go with... this Intellivision game, going from, like, oldest to newest or something. So what do we got? We got... Don't I already have this? Is this for Intellivision, or is this... I'm confused, because... Hold on. Okay. I was really confused, because this is the Atari... cartridge. So at first glance it looked pretty similar, but as you can see they are a different size. So this is the Atari version. This is the Intellivision version, which I know most people be kind of upset with how similar they are, but the Intellivision graphics are better than Atari, so I'm kind of curious on how this looks. So I'm not disappointed, actually. I'm actually fine with that. But, yeah, you can see on why I was a little confused, because even the Atari version is slanted, and they both say Parker Brothers on it and all that. But, I mean, it doesn't say on here, though. I mean, it's Sega Enterprises, Inc. It doesn't at all say on this label what it's for. So that's interesting. Okay, cool. I'm curious on what Frogger and if you look right there, you'll see a video of it, so that way you'll be like, oh, what does that look like? Well, there you go, there's the video right there. Yeah. Okay. Okay, up next, I feel a Game Boy Advance game, which, usually, at least lately with my Game Boy Advance games, they've been pretty good choices. Lately it's been either Mega Man Battle Network or a Wario game. Unfortunately, they're Mega Man Battle Network Japanese versions, so good luck reading them. I mean, I guess if I have somebody with me, they can basically put their phone up to the screen to translate for me. But, we can make it work. But let's see what we got. We got... Wow, I called it. So we got Mega Man Battle Network 2 on Game Boy Advance. Wow, this is like my third Battle Network game in a row, it feels like. I know I've gotten 3 or 4, like, in the past, within a year, probably like in the last 6 months or something. I'm not upset, though. I know these are good games. I just wish I can read Japanese. But I guess the American versions are more expensive. I don't mind Japanese platformer games, but when it comes to RPGs, it is kind of nice to know what the characters are saying, so that way you kind of know what you're doing, what you're selecting, what the missions are, etc. But like I said, we'll make it work if you guys want to see one of the Mega Man Battle Network games. Anyway. So then next I feel a PS4 game. So we got Star Wars Squadrons on PS4. I hope I don't need the VR to play this. Realize your Star Wars pilot fantasy like never before with optional VR. Okay, cool. So this is optional. So if I have VR, PlayStation, because I've got the Oculus, but I don't think that's compatible with the PlayStation, but that's cool. So I'm sure this is a fun game, basically a flight sim in the Star Wars universe. Some of those are fun games. This came out 2020. All right. So we got one more game. Okay, yeah, this is definitely Xbox One. I can feel the Xbox logo at the top. And we got Forza 5, Day 1, 2013. Wow. So, is this this is a launch title, I'm assuming, because I remember when I got my Xbox One, I got Dead Rising 3, and that was also a Day 1 edition that I got, because that was the game I got with my Xbox One. And also came out in 2013. So I'm assuming this is like a launch title, which is pretty cool. Launch titles are always something that intrigue me, because it's like, it shows like on what was initially available when the game console first came out. Sometimes you have a very strong launch for a console. Sometimes you got a really weak launch. I mean, like, the 64 was... I'm conflicted. Like, that's one of the... I want to say that's, like, one of the weakest launches, but you have Mario 64, like, one of the, like, most groundbreaking games of all time, and Pilot Wings. So you only have two games, but... when one of those is Mario 64, that's already kind of a strong lineup. But maybe we'll talk about that one of these days. Go through console launch titles or something. So anyway, yeah, that is it in this box. So here they're giving instructions for the boss chest giveaway, which you basically take a picture of your stuff, post on social media, and you're entered the boss chest giveaway, which... a lot of times is a game console. I remember the very first one I entered was for a Sega Master System, because I didn't have one at the time. So that could be a way to get a Master System and then get games for your console. I know a PS1 was one. I think a Genesis was probably one as well. So those are fun ways to potentially win a new game console for your collection, and then you can get games from RGT for your collection. So that's pretty cool. And then there you go, you got treasure. So yeah, I'd say this is a pretty good box. And I think one of the things I want to start doing, I might forget in the first couple videos because it's kind of a new thing, but for one, picking my pick of the box, which is kind of difficult. Not one of these really stands out above the others. I mean, probably Battle Network. But I know Forza is pretty good too, so I'd say probably one of those being my my pick of the box. And I know that a lot of people like to put the value and see, hey, did I do good in this box, or did I lose out on this box? So yeah, I posted prices for all those games, and did I win or did I lose? We'll find out there. But I got a lot of games to show off, so let's go ahead and get started on that. I guess I'll clear off this and then get started. So I got this at GameStop. I've been looking for this game for a while, so I was excited to find it. Unfortunately, it's loose. I'd love to get the case at some point, because even though I have all my... Game Boy Advance and DS games in a binder, I still have all my cases of games that I have cases for. So I'd love to get the cases to make all my DS and 3DS games complete in box. But I got Hotel Dusk, which is I saw BoxJump play it on Twitch once. It looked really cool, and I only saw like about a half hour of it or something. But it looked really interesting. It's like 1979 or something. You're a detective or ex-detective in a hotel where there was a murder, and you're trying to, like, solve the murder. And it's visual novel, and it looked pretty cool. So I was excited to finally find that, pick that up. A few other games that I got. I got Yakuza 0, The Song of Life, Essence of Art Edition, which is really cool. This, it has, it obviously has the disc there, but it also has, like, an art book at the same time. I mean, look at this. Look how cool that is. It's very nice. I mean, I'd love to show off all of this, but, I mean, we got a lot of games to show off, but, I guess if you want to see this in more detail, demand a brief video or something, but I'm almost done showing off all the pages anyway. There you go. $10. So that was pretty exciting to pick that up. I also got Dungeon Siege 3, which I learned I already have, but my copy, I think I got through RGT, and it's sealed. So I'm going to keep that one sealed, and then this is one that I can play it. I don't have one or two, but that's fine. I'll pick up one and two at some point, but I was excited to pick that one up. And my cousin turned me on to steelbooks, steelcases and stuff. So if I find a steelcase that looks really nice and is relatively cheap or at least affordable and looks really good, I'll go ahead and pick it up. So look at this. Oh, this is really nice. So I got a steelcase for Assassin's Creed Valhalla, which I have on PS5, but now I got it on PS4 for the steelcase, and it's beautiful. Look at that artwork. That's very nice. I bought a few steel cases this month. This one being the first. I picked up Octopath Traveler on the Switch. I wanted to get this one pretty much since it came out, because I've not beaten the first one, but I've played a little bit of the first one and I enjoyed it. And people say that the grinding is much easier in this one, so that way you're not grinding as much, which is really nice. They dropped the price from $60 to $30, and I thought, oh, in that case, I gotta get it. So I picked up Octopath Traveler, so I was excited to add another great Switch game to the collection. And I got Kirby Planet Robobot on 3DS. I don't know if this is complete. I mean, you got like this manual. I don't know if there's an actual manual or not, but at least it has the case. So anyway, I got that one. And I got Steel Rising. I don't know anything about this game, but it was a $10 PS5 game. It looked interesting from the gameplay right here. It looks kind of cool. So maybe this might be a hidden gem that might be like a new favorite on the console. Who knows? Another steel case. I don't know anything about Tenten. I just know that he's like the comic book kid with the dog. But another very nice steel case. Oh yeah, look at that. That's really nice. And you have these, like, postcard things. So you got that one, and that one, and that one. So that's all very nice. So I was excited to add that. And, I guess I'll show off the pre-order bonus for this game, and then I'll show off what it is. I mean, it's not really spoiling anything if I'm going to show you in the next minute. I got Final Fantasy VII Rebirth. This is the GameStop pre-order bonus. You get a hat. Shocker if I were to say that I got... Well, I guess it's kind of a shocker if I say I got the deluxe edition, which is very nice. So, first is obviously the standard game, which I realized I don't have part one, and this is part two, so it's kind of hard to enjoy Rebirth if you don't have the first part yet. So I'll pick that up. But I mean, this was only like $30 more to get the deluxe edition. Oh, and I guess the camera's showing off this, so I'll show this. This is the steel case for the deluxe game, and that's not much on the inside. Why are there two? Oh, I guess it is a two-disc game. Wow, two-disc game on PS5. It's got to be a massive game, especially if it's broken up into... I mean, this is part two. There's a third part coming. Anyway, yeah, this is beautiful. Look at that. And no surprise that there's a pretty hefty art book here. So I won't go through every page, but I mean, it's got stuff like that. That's really nice. Obviously, it's got all of her characters in it. Yeah, so you got that, and then you got some of the enemies and monsters and the weapons. It's a very nice steel case, or a very nice art book steel case. It's beautiful, everything. So yeah, I was excited to add this, and I gotta clear off the table because I got a lot more stuff. March was more expensive than I wanted it to be, but I guess all I can say is I'll behave, or try to behave more, in April. GameStop had a really nice sale a couple weeks ago where it was the buy four for $20 that are $10 or less, or buy four for $40 for games that are $20 or less. So I took advantage of that. I got more games than I should have, but I got 16 games for $110. So you can't really, I mean, yeah, you can beat that, but that's hard to beat. So anyway, let's show off what games I got. I got another steel case. I got the Shadow of Mordor Game of the Year Edition on PS4. Oh, it's beautiful. I mean, you got like the map on the inside, and just look at that. That's so nice. So anyway, I got that. And so I got... Yeah, I'll just show off all the games. I won't go into detail on... I went to two different locations. Anyway, I got The Outer Worlds, which I don't really know anything about this game, but it kind of has a Fallout vibe to it with, I don't know, just kind of this futuristic wasteland looking thing. I don't know, it just, I hear it's good, and the gameplay right there looks good too, so that's exciting. I got Twisted Metal on PS3. Unfortunately, it's not complete. It's missing the manual. Ooh, I didn't even realize this. This is, I mean, I even checked that it's not complete, but I didn't realize it's got a reversible cover, which that's something I learned, that some PS3 and PS2 games even had reversible sleeves. So I kind of want to get a lot of those now. This was one that I just got because it was a Twisted Metal game, because Twisted Metal's an iconic series on the PlayStation. So anyway, I got that. Now, this was a game I got through Retro Game Treasure, but it was loose. I hate that it was loose. So I got Injustice 2. This is the Legendary Edition, which I think is... it's got more stuff, apparently. I don't know if that's through code or actually on the disc, but at least I have it on a in the case. That's kind of the important part. I hate having loose disc-based games. I got Sonic and All-Stars Racing Transformed on the Wii U, which I always find funny. Why does Sonic need to drive a car? I saw a joke that it was because that's the only way for Sonic to be fair. Otherwise, he'd just destroy everybody because he's Sonic the Hedgehog. He's fast. But... Wait a minute, what? You can play as Wreck-It Ralph in this game? What? Oh, that's cool. All right. Yeah, play Wreck-It Ralph and Sonic the Hedgehog. All right, that's cool. Next is Ni No Kuni on PS3, which I don't really know much about Ni No Kuni, but as soon as I saw the gameplay that you're seeing right here, I'm like, oh, that's a beautiful game. Like, I mean, yeah, I know it's dated, it's PS3 graphics. But I'm just like, wow, I really like the art style in that. It's really nice. It's like Studio Ghibli or Disney level, like, animation and artwork and stuff. It's very nice. Yeah. I got Wolfenstein 2, The New Colossus, because I thought I had this, but I don't think I do. I've got a couple of the other Wolfenstein games. Like the, what is it called? Like the New Order or something? I don't know. Future Me is putting the other games that I got there. But I don't think I have this one. So, yeah, I added another Wolfenstein game to the collection. I got Like a Dragon Ishin, however you say that. And this one looks like it actually takes place like in... old time Japan, whereas a lot of the other Like a Dragon and Yakuza games take place in more modern day. Because isn't that the same series? Isn't Like a Dragon and Yakuza like part of the same series or something? I don't know. I've never played these games. I don't play games. I mean, if you guys have seen the stuff on the channel or the stuff on Three Way Stop, like the Tiny Toons Adventure, I don't get a chance to play a lot of games. And when I do, I'm bad. But it's fun to collect them. And, it's fun to hopefully play them and be okay at them. A second GameStop adventure, the same day, same sale. I got Gungrave Gore on Xbox Series X. I've watched the anime. I really enjoyed the anime. So I don't know how well this ties into the anime, if the anime is its own thing or not. But I'm intrigued by it. I mean, I recognize that's, Brandon Heat or, Beyond the Grave, they call him. I'm intrigued to check that one out. This one looked kind of cool. World War One, like Italian, graphics look really nice, and I guess you're like reenacting some of the battles that the Italians fought in World War One. I don't know. I don't know anything about this game. I don't really know about too much of the Italians' play in World War One. I know they were there, and I know that they were on the Allies' side, but between World War One and Two, they joined. The Axis, the German ally side, and I know they didn't really do too much from my basic World War II knowledge. I know they didn't do a lot in World War II, but I don't know. I especially don't know what they did in World War I. But maybe this will teach me a little bit. So that's cool. I got Payday 2 on PS3. Unfortunately. Not complete, but it looks like a fun game, and I think I saw Kajinama play this once, and it looked pretty fun, or at least one of the Payday games, I think. But anyway, it looked cool. So I figured I'd add that, especially since it's part of... I got that for $5. Probably even less than $5, because like I said, it was $110 for all these games. I got Mortal Kombat XL, which is basically a slightly better version of Mortal Kombat X, which I do have that one already. But this one includes additional characters and skin packs, which is probably DLC stuff. I don't know. But since I have XL now, I guess I'll sell my copy of Mortal Kombat X. But anyway, yeah. And speaking of Mortal Kombat, I got Mortal Kombat on the 360. I looked this up. This is basically Mortal Kombat 9 is what they call this one. So this one, X being 10, this one being 9. But I picked up two Mortal Kombat games. Pretty cheap. That's weird. Why is that one cheaper than... That one's more expensive than this one. This is a newer game. And 9 is more expensive than 10. Weird. I mean, I guess not really, because I got them both for $10. Less than $10, but theoretically it's more expensive. I got Rainbow Six Extraction on PS4. Gameplay on this one looked pretty fun, so I'm excited to check out some of the stuff myself on some of the Rainbow Six games. Just Cause was another one that looked really fun. It looked really cool how you got like this, not really wings, but you got like the little glider thing, so you're kind of gliding around and everything, and, purchase for your chance to win an island? I'm sure they mean like in-game, not an actual island, although that would be really cool to win an actual, like, private island. I'm sure that's, a long gone, thing. And I picked up this game recently, but I saw the steel case and I'm like, oh, I love this steel case. So I picked up Hot Wheels Unleashed on the Xbox One or Xbox Series X steel case. I'll hold on to both copies because they look different, but I really like that steel case. So this was all in one day, and this was just a little over $100 for all this, which was an amazing deal. So, I guess I'm going to clear this off for round three. Here's a game that I've been looking for like, the last 12 years, 11 years, something like that. I've been looking for this for a while. Ever since I watched Game Grumps play this during the JonTron days, by the way. Tells you how long that is for those that are familiar with Game Grumps. Remember, JonTron left in 2013, so and they started in 2012, so there's only like less than a year. Anyway, Goof Troop. I've wanted to play this game for quite a while. I finally found it, so I'm like, oh, I am definitely getting that game. So I got Goof Troop. This was when Capcom games, Disney games that were done by Capcom, like a lot of those are just very good games. Not all of them, but I know a lot of the Super Nintendo era, and even some of the NES era, are generally pretty good. I'm excited to play that one. I got Ape Escape 3 on PS2. So now I have the trilogy of Ape Escape games, because the first one was on original PlayStation, and 2 and 3 were on PS2. And there's one on the PSP, which I still need, but as far as, like, the trilogy, I guess, the ones that people know about, I have the trilogy now, so that's exciting. And shout out to Delphic Knight on my server, who donated a game to the collection from her personal collection, was Endless Ocean Blue World on the Wii. It is complete in box. There's a new Endless Ocean game coming out on the Switch, by the way. But, she says she put many, many hours into this game. I'm honored to have it in my collection. I'm hoping to play it on the channel at some point. I know that she's joked and said, maybe we'll play it on the channel. It's kind of a death sentence to playing games because it's slow-moving as far as playing games on the channel, because I don't know, just life, everything gets in the way and everything. But yeah, it's a beautiful looking game. I mean, like, just swimming around and looking at all the fish. Yeah, so I'm excited to add that one to the collection. So then I went to GameStop today, and I found, okay, I don't do sports games, like, ever, but when you find a steel case for under a dollar, yeah, I'm going to pick it up. So, I mean, it's not all that flashy for a steel case, but, I mean, it's not bad. You got Jackie Robinson there. At least it's a guy I've heard of. I don't know a lot of sports ball people, but yeah, it's a decent steel case. Like I said, for a dollar, I'm gonna get it. But I really went there for Showtime Princess Peach, or Princess Peach Showtime. Came out Friday. So I was excited to pick this one up. So Princess Peach, you got all these outfits, and I'm assuming they all do different things. Yeah, I'm excited to play this one. Princess Peach, I find her annoying sometimes, but I don't, like, hate her or anything. I used to be like, ew, it's Princess Peach, she's annoying. So, anyway, after I left that GameStop, I went to a different game store. I've never been to this one before, and the location was the weirdest place I've ever seen. The location was actually inside of the elementary school that Fruit, or Citrus, whatever you want to call him on the channel now. I mean, he prefers to go by Fruit now, but he's still kind of Citrus on the channel. Anyway, his elementary school got turned into a bunch of shops in the classrooms, one of them being a game store. So I'm like, this is weird. So imagine walking through a school, the basement of a school, and then you're like, oh, there's the game store. Yeah, just imagine that, elementary school. Anyway, I got, Crash Bandicoot Warped, which, it's weird because I could have sworn I had this game, but, I mean, it's on my wish list. But anyway, this is in really good shape. Oh, the only issue I have is, you can kind of see there that the spine, there's gotta be a way to fix that. If you guys know how to fix that, let me know, because, I want that to be straightened up instead of slanted like that. But anyway, I picked up Crash Bandicoot Warped. I was about to check out, and one of the employees came in with a box of games and game consoles and stuff. And, well, I found Mario Strikers Charged on Wii. And I'm like, hey, I know that you haven't really marked it yet, but I kind of want that game because it's complete. So, anyway, I got Mario Strikers Charged. So, now I've got Mario Strikers. Hey, we've got Mario Strikers, and I've got Mario Super Sluggers, which is Mario Baseball. I don't remember if I have the Mario Tennis game, or was the Mario Tennis game just the GameCube? I think the GameCube with a... I think the Mario Tennis was just, the new play control. So I think now that gives me all of the Mario sports games, unless I count this GameCube one, which I do have Mario Power Tennis on GameCube, but if I want to get it again on Wii, so I kind of have all the Mario sports games on Wii. Anyway, so I got that. Now, I already have this game, but this is the complete-in-box version of Jack 2. See, there you go. Complete-in-box. Which, one of the fun things I learned is Jack 2 is one of the few PS2 games with a reversible sleeve. I found a video on YouTube where the guy has the entire North American PS2 library, and he shows off all of the... reversible spines. So since I have this game in front of me, here we go. So there's that, and the back, and that's what the inside looks like. It's a map, which pretty cool. So, if you guys have Jack 2, you guys probably didn't know. Some of you guys did, but a lot of you guys probably didn't know that it has a reversible back. I know there was a BMX game that has it. Now, as far as games in my collection, now that's my third or fourth. It's one of the SOCOM games has it. Magna Carta has it. And what was the other game in my collection? Genji. That was the other one. Those are just the games I have in my collection. But look up a list and just... I'm going to probably start collecting all of those just because it's like, what, 12 games or 15 games or whatever. I just think that's a really neat feature, so I kind of want to get all those games now. And then the last game I got at this place, I didn't know this game existed, or I forgot that it existed. This is my first long case PlayStation game, so I kind of wanted to get it just because it was different. But it's called Revolution X, some kind of weird shooting game, but, for the music fans out there, featuring Aerosmith. So, I don't really know what role Aerosmith plays in this, but it involves Aerosmith in some way. Maybe the manual says something. Game features. Let's go to game features. No, game features, just that. But yeah, this is a really early PlayStation game. Because I want to say that the long boxes were all basically launch titles. Yeah, this came out in 1995. But I've never seen this game. It's weird. The guy that I bought it from said it was weird. I'm intrigued by weird. So that is all the games that I got. But I got one more thing I want to show you guys. I'm going to turn this camera off for a second. And then you'll see the new thing I got. All right, and what you're looking at is the Retron 5. So, in case you're wondering, like, dude, why'd you get a Retron 5? You already can play all those games already. Yeah, I can, but I have a few reasons. So, for those who don't know what this is, the Retron 5 can play 5 different game consoles. Here is a Game Boy slot, which can play original Game Boy, Game Boy Color, Game Boy Advance. This one can play Famicom games. This is regular NES games. This one is Super Famicom and Super Nintendo. And then this one is Sega Genesis games. And, this is for, the controller. It comes with, both this controller and another controller. Future Me post a picture of the other controller. That, I hate it. It's ugly. It's really loud and clicky, and it doesn't feel good. Whereas at least this feels like a standard, slightly cheaper, but just feels like a standard Super Nintendo controller. But I got this for a few different reasons. For one, you can load on translation patches for, well, whatever translations are available. So, some of those Japanese import games that I got through, like, Retro Game Treasure and stuff, not all of them. There's some that I really wish they would have, but, some of them have translation patches where you can play the Japanese game in English. So, 2 years ago, I got Fire Emblem on the Super Famicom. Well, it's on the Super Famicom, but it never came over to America, but that's okay. Because thanks to this, and thanks to that translation patch, I can play that Fire Emblem game in English. I've got Secret of Mana on Super Famicom. I can play that on this in English. I tried a few different games. I have a couple Famicom RPGs, Dragon Ball RPG games, and some Shonen Jump RPG game. I can play those in English, thanks to the Retron 5. So, the translation patch was one of the big reasons why I got this. as well as an adapter for the Genesis slot, where you can play, you can play Master System games on it, but that's fine. I already got a Master System. But you can also play through that adapter Sega Game Gear games, which I don't have that adapter yet. I'm going to get that probably next month or something. But you can play Game Gear games on the Retron 5, which means that you can play these on the TV, which means I can record them on the channel. So that was really cool. And shout out to Viro, because Viro is the one who told me about the Retron 5. He recently got on his channel a month or so ago. And I'm like, you know what, that's pretty cool. I'm going to get this on for myself as well, and here we go. I got the exact same model. But Viro pointed out that you can also have cheat codes on this thing, which coming soon, there's a new episode of Three Way Stop with me, Viro, and Citrus, a.k.a. Fruit, where we were playing through Battletoads, which, well, don't even bother watching my screen. I pretty much raged the entire time. I mean, I basically showed the angry monkey side, or the angry of the angry monkey. Yeah. We all agreed to infinite lives, but the infinite lives glitch or cheat, I was able to play on the Retron 5. So like on that game, you can have infinite lives or invincibility. On Mario, the original Mario game, you can have no enemies, or jump and get big, or jump and get small if you want that, and everything invisible, or the ground invisible but not you, or you are invisible but not the ground. I don't know, weird stuff like that. Automatically start with 1,000 points or 1,000,000 points or something stupid. There's a lot of weird things, so it's almost like having the Game Genie built into the Retron 5. So I think that's pretty cool. So yeah, I got it for a couple different reasons, and the cheats was just a third reason to get this. So I had that little off-brand Famicom, and I basically swapped that out for this guy, and he is able to fit perfectly right side by side by the... Oh yeah, the other reason, there is no way to record the Super Nintendo or the Sega Genesis through my capture card, or even through my old way of the DVD recorder. So that was one of the few reasons why I never recorded any Super Nintendo games on the channel, because I didn't really have a proper way to record those. Thanks to this, I can record Super Nintendo games and Genesis games on the channel. Now, as far as Atari games, that was also running through coax, but I can play those through the 7800, which I have over there. So yeah, there were three major reasons. Like I said, translation patch, the adapter for Game Gear, and being able to play SNES and Genesis on the channel. So I think that was a pretty worthwhile investment for the Retron 5. So anyway, I just wanted to show that off, save it for last, because it was kind of like the big thing. Next month, I doubt there will be a big thing like this. I don't want to have a big thing every month, because that's... It's kind of expensive to have a big thing every month, but anyway, I had a lot to show. This video ran on way too long, but I knew it would. But I enjoyed showing everything off and talking to you guys a little bit more. And yeah, I guess that's all I really have to say. So I guess I'll wrap up this video. If you haven't yet, don't forget to subscribe and like the video. Hit the bell so you're notified when another video comes out, whether that's another Let's Play video or another pickup video or an unboxing video. BoxyCon is probably going to be the next thing you guys will see, but maybe, maybe not. The three-way stop that I did with Viro and Fruit, that's going to be coming up soon, of us playing through Battletoads. Just watch Fruit's screen. He's the one to watch on that. Don't even bother even listening to me. I also have a Facebook where I post these videos on Facebook, so you can, I don't know, watch these on Facebook if you want to. I also have an Instagram where I forget that I have until I make these videos. Same old on all that. But most importantly, I have a Discord where you can follow me on Discord, and we can talk about video games and anime, Pokemon, post memes, talk about nostalgia. We got a lot of good stuff on the Discord. So all you need to do is just say, I want to join your Discord. I'll send you an invite, and we can have fun, hang out, nerd out, as I always say. Well, it is like 1 a.m. I am very tired, so I'm going to turn this camera off and then go to bed. And, so thank you for watching. Hope you enjoy the rest of your day.
Oh, yeah. One more thing I forgot to mention, guys. In March of 2024, the channel hit 200 subscribers, which is awesome. I mean, it took like 8 or 9 years to hit my first 100, and only like a year, year and a half for my next 100. So, yeah, thank you, everybody. You guys are all awesome. And let's try to get 300 subscribers throughout 2024. All right, I just wanted to say that little announcement real quick. Anyway, like I said, you guys are awesome. Thank you for subscribing. For those who haven't, don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you guys in another video. Goodbye.